GM, GM, everyone. We are here live with Thea. She's gonna be coached by me today, playing the meta decks for each parallel.
Yeah, guys, I am new to parallel. I will actually be casting my very first game with Quinto, as well as with Aliestra and all those other cool people on Thursday. I'm so happy to be part of this new card game community. Yeah, I've been playing TCGs and CCGs all my life, and this one grabbed my attention because they were doing some awesome things in the card game world. So yeah, thanks Quinto for teaching me how to play the meta decks. I really appreciate it. Hopefully everybody watching can also learn a thing or two today with us.
Oh my god.
What's happening?
This guy is Sekinox from YGG. He's probably a top 10. He's a top 10 player, so let's see.
Okay, let's destroy him.
Yeah, let's do it. Let's do it.
Okay.
So yeah, you want here, you can, yeah, you can read, you can select that Gaia's Call, just take it back, and they both effects. Those are called ceremonial rites. And yeah, you can go like this. The Steward of the Garden, which is the one cost card, it ramps, gives you one energy at the start of your next turn.
Okay.
And the Cunning Diplomat is a defender unit that helps with cycling your deck. So here you're starting, right?
Yes.
This deck has the passive ability that it drops these Juggernaut tokens that cost zero energy. So that card on the right called the Fixer helps you with that, the four cost card. Yeah, destroy target's enemy with cost two or less. So we might want to hold it.
Okay, and get rid of a two, I assume.
Well, the thing is that we need the defenders here also. So I would go like, I would go, I guess, bank the, this is the tricky part where we have to, bank the Aurora Fungi, which is an upgrade, and play the Sui. This way we keep our defenders, which is important in this matchup, because the deck that we're playing against has an OTK.
Okay.
That if attacks phase, basically will kill you when he plays it, so defender helps us with preventing that. Ooh. So here we would like to draw first with a Cunning Diplomat. Just drop it, one of the two. You don't have to bank first because you have that energy, so you can play it.
Got you.
Always draw first. And we get another Fixer. Yeah.
Yeah, that's a cool card.
Which we can bank. We can bank one of the Fixers, the four cost. And yeah, we can. You can end it here.
Oh, so this doesn't have any attack. Okay.
No, it doesn't have an attack. Yeah.
This card is to block.
When a player starts second, they get that unit you see there, the Shield Pot, which is a 0/2 unit that basically doesn't do anything. You can't attach anything to it. Can't do basic. It basically doesn't benefit from anything.
Yeah,
just,
I see.
Some buffs it can benefit from, but you can't attach upgrades, for example.
So I understand.
Yeah, this one cost card that he dropped is a Harleek Pilot, very annoying unit. That if you don't kill it soon, it's gonna be a pain. So I would go and draw again first. Establish the
draw.
You can draw cards with a Cunning Diplomat, the two cost card.
Got you.
To see what do we get.
Okay.
First, it's something. Yeah, this card is very strong. Wong. It's five cost cards that looks into your deck and buffs units depending on the types of cards you draw. So you can bank that one cost card, the Grove Guardian. You can bank him.
Got
and
you.
I would play the other Cunning Diplomat.
So do we have a hand limit in parallel?
Yeah, it's you can see it there to the left. It's eight.
Eight
cards.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh wow, none of our cards can attack. We're pretty passive. So I just pass?
Yeah.
Okay. I guess, in turn. Okay, so the... So how many factions are there in parallel? Like six?
There are five parallels. Yeah, here you can defend basically with anything.
Okay, there's five. And which one am I playing right now?
You're playing Earthen.
Earthen, okay.
Yeah. So here, the Krubos, you see the card, the five-cost card, you can actually play it here, the Krubos. But let me see. You can play now. You will need to bank something first. Let me think. What can you right-click the Heartlink pilot that he has there to see which upgrade? Like you can see the upgrade there.
Yes.
It's that ocular implant. Mm. Here you can play the Paragon. I would play the Paragon, which is Nehemiah. You can just grab the Paragon. You see it to the left.
Paragon.
The hero.
Yes.
Hero. You can play it. This will buff all your units. So the unit with Defender, they make it so that it equals their attack equals their health. So now you have like a lot of attack there, and here you can clear the whole board by yeah.
Let's do it. Waiting for opponent. Oh, okay, it's their turn.
Yeah. When the Heartlink pilot has defender has an upgrade, it has defender also.
Okay. Attack. And then I go face, right? Yes.
Yeah, you go face. And,
can't play with
and
that
you need to bank. Wait, you need to bank. Bank the two cost card. The student of Shoshana. Yeah.
You're good. Gotcha. Okay. So when I play my Paragon, immediately something happens on deploy, and I can't attack with it yet until the next turn, right?
Yeah, you can't attack until next turn after dropping.
Gotcha. Are we doing good so far in this matchup?
Yeah, we're doing okay.
It seems like we're doing okay. And I can drop my Paragon once, right?
Yeah, once.
Gotcha.
So what I will do here, you can... So this effect that you draw is called... ceremonial rites. So you have the options to attack face, like drop the Krubos and attack face, for example.
I like that.
Yeah, and there's the three cost card. You can drop it. You can bank that three cost card and drop the Krubos and just smack his face as soon as possible. Yeah. Do that.
That's the type of player I am. If you can get me an aggro deck where I can just go face,
that's what I want to do. We will get to that one. That's the red one, the Markolian. So here we... Ooh, annihilate. Nice. Nicely done by him. So you can give defender to the Krubos now? As that's the passive ability of this Paragon. You can give, yeah.
Okay.
So the idea here is for you to defend in a way that your stuff doesn't get killed, like that.
Okay.
And no.
Oh shit! I'm sorry.
Yeah, no worries.
I was on a roll.
No worries, got excited. No worries. So here, what we can do? Yeah, well, you got another one.
Okay. Nice.
Here you can actually. Well, you can bank the effect, the two cost effect.
Uh-huh. Ceremonial rites.
Yeah. Drop the Krubos again. Doesn't matter. And just attack face. Keep attacking face. There's a card that is very very aggro. That you will get eventually. Well, formidable presence. So yeah, let's see if he has trouble dealing with your board.
I'm playing Earthen, and he's playing?
He's playing Augencore.
Augencore, okay.
Augencore, yeah. So he played Wong here. This is good for you.
Okay.
Well, kind of.
Yes.
Well, this is not good that it buffed. No, don't defend with that. No.
Okay, I won't.
Defend with a 1-3.
Okay. Oh, I didn't know I had the option.
Yeah, you can defend with different stuff. Yeah.
Okay. And now should I add something
else? Yeah, you add it to the crew boss.
Okay. All right. So what was that? The waste. Okay, something died.
Yeah.
Got you.
So now what we're gonna do is to you can bank that one cost unit that you just draw, and play Wong, the 5-cost card. No, not that one. The other one, yeah.
Wong. Got
so you. you're gonna get a screen where you have to select the cards.
Okay.
And in this screen, you will select Gaia's Call, the 4-cost card, and one of the Stewies in this case. Yeah, that one and one. Yeah, that's okay.
Okay.
Boss itself. So now, what you're gonna do is to attack face, and play the 1-cost card that you just draw. And that's it.
All right. And in turn.
Yeah. So basically, if you get the card that I mentioned, which is the Formidable Presence, you should be okay already. You also have that 8-cost card called Tain, which is a legendary card. He's gonna destroy the whole board now by playing a card called AOP, most likely. So he's attacking. You shall defend with your 1-4 instead of that one.
Okay, the 1-4?
Yeah, the 1-4.
Gotcha.
And here you can give defender to the 1-5, the Stewie of the Garden, Steward of the Garden. Yeah.
Okay.
That one.
So how do you specifically pick your defenders? Just kind of based on their defense?
Yeah, based on the fact that I want to control the board in such a manner that it blocks their strategy, to say something. So he's gonna kill that now.
Another question, in parallel, do cards attack directly into each other at the same time? Or do I just take the damage from my end if they attack me? So if a 2-point attack attacks my card, does my card attack back into it in the same turn or not?
I would say if a 2-point cost card attacks
I'll give you an example. Don't worry, let's first finish this turn. I'll see in just a second. Okay, so what do you want me to play here? We've got 7 and we can back.
Yeah, you can play that 5 like you. Here you should play the the thing is that it's a bit of a trouble here because he might win next turn, but here you can play that card, the 5-cost card.
Okay.
Yeah.
Kozo. Master Kozo.
Yeah, and attach that to it.
Yes.
Maybe that that was not the best play, but
it's okay.
It doesn't matter. Play the, like, bank the 4. Yeah, that one. Bank that.
Gaia's Call.
Yeah, and you can use the Aurora Fungi on Kozo, I would say.
Okay.
Here, you're basically looking for, you can end the turn.
Okay. Alright, so we'll see now. If they attack...
No formidable.
If they attack my 4-point card, yep. Does my card, with 4 points, attack them back and damage them by 4 points.
Yeah, yeah, of course.
Gotcha.
It depends. If the card they are attacking with has armed, that means they can attack without getting damaged. But if the damage was less, it doesn't matter. It functions like. So if you attack and don't kill the unit, it works as normal. Like your unit will attack back because it didn't kill it.
Yeah, I've played many different TCG card games and it's always interesting to me. Some will, there you go. Some will attack into each other. With others, you just damage and nothing happens to the card attacking. But I like this format. It's very similar to my other card game I'm playing.
So here we're looking for one card and you win, basically.
Which one?
It's called Formidable Presence. So we should get it now.
Come on.
Oh my god.
Oh.
so yeah, here. You want to play that the 4-cost card? That one. Destroy upgrades. Yeah, this might be over the next turn. But
okay, it's okay. It's a very strong game.
Yeah, bank the 2-cost card. You can bank the student.
Okay.
And drop Koso again.
Koso.
Yeah, Koso returns to your hand, and keeps on revealing stuff. Yeah, you can play that. That's a relic. It's called Reclamator. Yeah, in that part of the board.
Nice. Okay.
So
very nice. Enter.
Yeah, enter. Hopefully we get. Still no. Well.
So, in this specific meta matchup, what went wrong? How should we have stop them? Should we have had more defenders? Did they just get rid of our defenders very well and now we're kind of in trouble?
No, the thing is that we need to kill them. That's the thing.
And we're struggling to put cards on the board and keep them there.
I mean, if we get the card, we still win.
Okay.
I'm talking about.
What does our card do?
It pops like three units that do 2 damage each.
Oh, yes, I love those.
And we can,
It's like a wide damage.
Yeah. No! Oh. No way!
Oh.
Oh my god.
No. Okay.
So what we're gonna do is use the Cleanse the Earth, which is a 2-cost card you have there. Okay. Yeah, that one. And return the 3-cost card, which is the Scrap Heap Salvager, the one that has an upgrade. Yeah, that one. Return it to his hand. And bank the Gunslinger, the one you have in the hand. Yeah, bank that. And this time play Tain. That's it.
Tain.
Yeah.
Tank.
Yeah.
Decay.
Still
at the start of your turn, this unit and any adjacent units.
Still no for me presence. Yeah, hopefully he doesn't have the OTK. He might have the damage to kill you. I don't know. Yeah.
So what does OTK stand for here?
OTK means one turn kill. So there's a card this deck runs. You're going to see it when you play it. We're going to play with it. Yeah, maybe what I did wrong was we should have played this card, Tain, a couple of turns ago. It would have already most likely be over.
That's
I don't know why I didn't. Like, yeah, he just destroyed it.
So our opponent seems to be an experienced player. As a somebody with my rank, how are we facing them this early on?
Yeah, because you're in the placements. You I guess the game wants to see.
Oh, okay, I understand. It's still trying to see if I'm an experienced player. I gotcha.
Yeah. Okay. So we're gonna be okay now, because, well, let's see first if he doesn't destroy the relic. Yeah, we're gonna be okay for one more turn. If we get that formidable, we win. Formidable! Oh my god. So, what we're gonna do here is to play Cleanse the Earth, right? Yeah, play that. And you're gonna return... you're gonna return the Nestor, the zero cost unit, and the same that you returned before. Yeah. That one. No. And the other. You have to click the three cost one, the scrap heap. Yeah, and confirm. Yeah.
Those. There we go.
Yeah. So now you're gonna play that one cost card you have there called Primean Conduit. This card buffs with the amount of energy you have. So
okay.
This way now you have like a big wall to defend.
Mm-hmm. Nice.
Because you will have that eight attack unit, and then you will get the defender with Tain. So yeah, end the turn.
Okay.
We don't draw any more cards because you only draw cards at the end of the turn if you have if you bank. So now you don't get any more cards.
So for any of my new players coming from my community, how much cards can you have in a deck?
40 cards.
40, and yeah. You can't have less or more, just 40.
40 cards and that's it. So okay. Now you give defender to Tain. Yeah, 40 cards, it's yeah, give defender, confirm.
So us not drawing that card is statistically pretty poopy.
Yep.
The fact that we haven't gotten
yeah.
it yet.
Yeah,
gotcha.
Yeah. The good thing with that card is that once you play it, you're safe against this deck. Because
okay.
it's those units that pop out are they can't destroy it. So I think you win. I think if he doesn't destroy your Tain. Yeah, Tain is a big chunky guy.
Big boy.
Big boy. Big boy.
Big chunker.
big chunky dude.
He's bigger than my cat. She's chilling in the corner. She's doing good. Okay. Yeah, this is cool. Is there a reason that card moves? Is it like a premium version of the card?
No. Well, yeah. There's different cards around.
Probably costs more to have a card that looks this cool.
Yeah, the thing is that if we don't get that formidable here. Please!
Come on!
Come on! Well, at least you have another one of these, so...
Okay.
So yeah, so you're gonna... What you're gonna do here is to play the Efrets.
Coster... Which one's that?
Wait. You're gonna play Efrets.
Efrets Attendant?
Yeah, Efrets. You're gonna play Kozo. Play Kozo.
So,
Keth, and attach Keth to Efrets. Doesn't matter.
Efret. Okay.
And now you play the Primean Conduit. The one cost card that you played before.
Gotcha. Primean Conduit. Primean Conduit.
Yeah. Okay. Let's hope he. I mean, at this point. At this point, he might just end it here. Can't believe you didn't get the formidable presence.
Like it's
you have
okay.
three there. So yeah, he most likely will end this now.
Which one? Chain.
So give defender to Kozo.
Kozo.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, you only get one only. No way, dude.
Oh no.
Yeah.
Oof.
Yeah.
Okay. It's a good start. It's fine.
Shouldn't be like that. Like it was. Yeah.
Changed but unbroken. I disagree. I feel broken.
Can't believe we didn't get the cards. Like, we just needed one. But well, no worries.
It's okay. So, the deck they were playing, is that something in the current meta that we have?
Yeah, it's the number one.
Can we try it?
Yeah, of course.
Let's do it. Okay. So, yeah, it's going to give me a good idea of what we were facing and how to navigate that deck. Okay, so we played the Earthen Parallel. Now we're going to play the... It's a weird word, like the Equino or something?
That's where Paragon's Dao comes into play, as I mentioned you. You don't have to buy the cards, we can rent them for you and you will get your earnings.
Oh, really? Yeah, I get earnings even if I borrow cards?
Yeah, we will do a split, but it's fine, you will get
earnings. Oh, so you make a little bit...
Without having to invest and buy.
Oh, so if you rent your cards out to me, you get a part of the earnings that I make?
Yeah, the part that... Whoa. Yeah.
Awesome.
Yeah, so
that's
here...
Awesome.
You can send back everything, I would say.
Okay. That's not good.
Okay, you... Not my... Not the
not,
perfect...
Yeah.
Not that... Not...
Not
still
great.
Not a nice hand, but it's okay, it's okay.
Yeah.
Oh my god, this card is super annoying. So, here, as you can see, you have that 3-cost card called Cathrexamine. That's a legendary card. Yeah, that one is used with the OTK. You can proceed and bank it, because that's a good thing about this deck. You can bank stuff, and you will use it later.
Okay.
Yeah, so, yeah, go ahead and just...
In turn. Okay.
We want to save the Fixer here, because probably we will be killing that one-cost unit that buffs itself every time it banishes something. So, the deck that we're playing against is called Shroud. That's a parallel. And they basically specialize in banishing stuff. They have a special place there instead of the Waste. Well, on top of the Waste, they have the Waste and the Singularity, so they can play cards from their Singularity. It's like a special mechanic only they have. So
okay.
Yeah. Here, we don't have anything to play, so we go ahead and bank one of the four-mans, one of the experts, automation experts, the one that you have three copies of.
Got you.
For a moment, I thought Quinto was going to say they have a special place in Hell.
I thought that too, but I have noticed you don't use that language easily. I also thought you were about to say that. He thought it, he just didn't say it out loud.
Yeah, so this is a problem. Now you have to see the Singularity, because if he banishes your combo cards, we're in a problem. So click there on its side where it says Singularity. Yeah, on top to the right. No that. No, not in the card. No. In the where the Waste is. Like
okay.
Yeah, on top of the end turn, yeah, there. You see Singularity?
Yeah, five.
The number five, yeah. So he didn't banish like the first two cards from left to right are yours.
Uh-huh.
He got them with that card that he just played.
Oh, so damn, okay.
Here we wanna like bank the Mercenary Gunslinger, the one cost card, and play the Star Shard. The Star Shard is a 3-cost card there.
All right.
We will just look into the combo as soon as possible. Yeah, this card helps you each time you draw. You look into the three top cards in your deck, and you can choose whichever you want.
Yeah, so it's nice for consistency.
Yeah, and to cycle
Star
the deck
charts.
Because
yes,
you cycle the deck in a deck that you need the combo. You will be cycling a lot.
Yes, got you.
We just have to basically tank damage now. So we got another Fixer. You can get the Fixer also. Yeah, the Fixer here. So that card, the four cost card, the Reclamator, when you bank it, it gives two energy. So you will get more energy when playing it. Yeah. So here, I guess we go with a Fixer, or wait, let me think. Yeah, I would go with a Fixer and kill the, that one, and kill that one cost card.
The Singularity.
Yeah, the Singularity Steward. Singularity Steward. Yeah. And now, when you end the turn, you will see that you will choose between a bunch of units. This is your passive.
Okay.
So, you can go with a... You're gonna go with a Defender, the one that 3-6 defends Juggernaut with Defender here. Might not be the best, he might banish it really quick, but it's fine.
If you kill a card in this game, do you say you banished it, or is banish a specific keyword used?
Yeah, the banish is specific for the parallel we're against, which is Shroud. You see, that card is Erasure,
gotcha.
Banishes a unit.
Yes. Interesting, I see.
Yep. Yeah, so he is I would not say overextending, because he has a lot of damage on the board. We didn't get like a quick start here. So yeah, when he banishes a unit, it goes to the Singularity. That card, the four cost card, it's called the Shepherd. If a card would enter the enemy waste, it goes to their Singularity. So that's very powerful right now against us, because it will buff that unit. So here, you want to select the Heartling Pilot is your best bet. The Heartling Pilot, the one cost card? Yeah, select that one. So this little dude is very... It has shielded. So it protects you from their like a bunch of effects they might have as a Shroud. So here you will like to bank the Graphene Battery, which is the two cost card you have there. It's so one of the cards used in the combo. And here I would say I would play another Fixer in this case. The Fixer to kill the chef, the other Singularity. Yeah.
Gotcha.
Next turn we might be able We might be able to drop the Heart Linked and attach Kill Switch, which is the upgrade, the three cost upgrade you have there.
So you don't want me to play it now?
No, because he's gonna kill it and we want to use it in another way.
Okay. Probably. So banish goes to Singularity, and I have ways to play them. Gotcha. Thank you.
Yeah, probably we're still in a pickle here, but it's fine. Let's see.
We had a rough start, to be fair. We didn't. Yeah. Our ramp didn't go nicely. We didn't get any ones or twos.
Yeah.
That's not our fault. It's okay. Are they playing a meta deck?
Yeah, they are playing a meta deck.
Okay. Do we own that deck?
Yeah, we owned it. So yeah, Okay. Choose the two cost card, the Graphene. Yeah, that one you're gonna bank it also.
Yeah, so we get seven.
Yeah.
No,
so
six.
Now you play the Heartlinked Pilot, the one cost card. Yeah.
Yes.
So this card has Salvage. It means that it can give the upgrade when it dies to another unit.
Okay.
So you're gonna attach the Kill Switch here to it.
Kill Switch.
Yeah,
yes.
And you're going to use a PS8 on the Baron, the two cost card he has, the Baron Squire, I think it's called.
Baron Squire, yeah.
So now we are hoping he doesn't banish the Heartling Pilot. He might be able to do it, but if he does it, we will have one turn more. Before we die.
Okay.
But it's fine.
So what's the ability you said she has that if she dies, something else happens? What is that word called? Salvage?
Salvage. So when it dies, it gives the upgrade it has attached to another unit.
Got you. is that a unit we want on my side of the board or in my hand?
Yeah, on our side. Yeah, he actually banished it.
Banished.
With Brandt, which is a paragon of his paragon. It when he attacks, it banishes. So yeah, we're kind of in a pickle here. But it's fine. Let's see if we get this.
Seems like a frustrating deck to play against.
Yeah, it's a frustrating deck to play against. But yeah. I think we had like a very bad hand.
We did. We did. Is this a good matchup for us normally, or is it a bad matchup?
It's fine. It is fine. It is a fine matchup. Like it.
Okay.
We should be able to win it, but in this case we had trouble with it.
Mm-hmm. Interesting. I like the mechanic though. I like the banish mechanic. I don't know in what card game I've seen this before. I don't know. It feels pretty unique. Like you kind of absorb the cards into your own singularity. It's very new to me. Choose a card from your deck. Let's see.
You can choose the kill switch here.
Yeah, I was thinking we do that.
So, at this point, we want to play the both automation experts in this case. And we just have to tank damage. I don't think we will be able to do much here anymore. So yeah, create a 2/3. Yeah, the Nestor, which has defender, and bank the other one.
Okay.
Yeah, and play the fixer on the one cost also.
Yeah.
And drop. And you get the defender token again. Yeah, end the turn and get your defender token.
Which defender one are we juggernaut,
taking? Defense juggernaut with defender, the second one. Yeah.
Does each of my defender cards get one opportunity a turn to be used? How?
Oof. Yeah. He beat us now.
Okay.
They can actually defend. If they survive, they can actually defend a couple of times. Yeah.
Okay.
Multiple times.
Poof. Ouch. It's all Gucci. Somebody's gonna get fired over this. Okay, so let's play that deck real quick. If you don't mind. We have two versions, I see.
You can play number 4, it's fine.
Okay.
Yeah. We will get it going. We will get it going. It's fine.
Yeah, it's all good. I'm sure after our rank placements, it will even out a little bit. Because right now we're just playing against everybody, right?
So, which parallel have you enjoyed so far?
So far? Honestly, I actually liked the very first one, the Earthen one. I'd like to try that one again. But maybe I'm just a bit biased because I don't know, I like the art. So normally that guides me a little bit. But we did lose that one, I think. But we almost didn't. It went quite well.
No, that was a win actually. If we would have like it was very like a lot of bad luck. Like we should have had that card ready to do that. So here I would say return everything. We need to look for our cheap cards. This annoying. These bad hands.
So we don't have confirmation these are being brought to the tourney. We just kind of assume it is because of the meta.
Yeah, it most likely will be these decks that you're gonna see. These are the decks that we're gonna see in the tournament For example, the one that we're playing against is the same. It's the same Augin Core deck that we have and that we lost against.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So here, we would like to bank, I guess, this the Unseen Allies. We can bank Unseen Allies, yeah. And just pass the turn. We got the Singularity Steward. Finally, a good card. Win-win! Oh my god.
Yeah. We've won. To be fair, most of them were just people dodging the queue.
Yeah. So what would you do here? Like, now that you know a bit of the cards and you have played, like, for example, the Cunning Diplomat.
Well,
yeah.
I see that we only have, I do like the Singularity. Yeah. Ooh, it's hard. Obviously, the Cunning Diplomat is nice since we can draw another card. I think my big thing would be wanting to know what I should bank. Normally, yeah. I bank bigger cards or cards that suck. I mean, I could kill this card with my Mercenary and play a Singularity in one turn.
Yep, that sounds like a good idea.
And then I wouldn't know what to bank. That's the only thing. I'm not sure if I should get rid of Erasure or keep
it.
You
can bank the Crewman, I guess, because this new card you have here, the Spectrecraft, it draws cards, and so it helps with cycling your deck.
Yeah, so that's what I would do, and I would kill her.
Yeah.
And then I would once again just want to know when we should play our parallel. Like, when do we make that decision?
Usually when you are like in a position to that's their board doesn't have any threats to you, I would say.
Okay, because I want to keep it alive.
Yeah.
Gotcha.
So here I would drop the Spectrecraft and bank the Acolyte. No.
Bank the Acolyte. Okay.
Yeah, the 2-cost card. Yeah, the Acolyte. Nullifier Acolyte.
Drop the Spectre attack.
Yeah, we would use Erasure on that unit, but it has shielded, so the effect won't go through.
Mm-hmm.
And you can attack phase with a Slinger here.
Mm.
That's it. Nothing else to do.
Shielded, immune to the next enemy effect card that targets it. Gotcha. Oh.
Yeah, so this card is very annoying as it buffs itself. This is possibly the worst card we could play against. The good thing is that we have the Spectrecraft has evasive, so it can attack whatever. If he drops the defender, you can attack with a Spectre and you draw a card. So that's very nice. Yeah, he dropped the defender here. Ooh, perfect. Finally got. Oh my god. So yeah, here you wanna... What you want to do is to use the Honor Steward against his security officer. Or, you know what? You can use the Honor Steward against his token. Even better. Yeah, you need to bank first. I would say we bank the Lord Harf. Yeah, that 2-cost card. And use the Honor Steward, the four cost card that you have.
Uh-huh.
Use him on the token, on the zero cost, the defense juggernaut.
Gotcha.
So the Honor Steward, when it banishes a unit, it goes to your singularity, but it goes back to the opponent. But when it's a token, it doesn't go back.
Okay.
So it's a free kill. So here I would say attack with a Spectre to the security officer. Yeah. We'll have to kill all our stuff in this trade, but it's fine. He doesn't have, I don't think he's running like a big meta deck. So
we running out of time?
Yeah, no, kill the, yeah, attack with your Singularity Steward to the officer. Uh-huh. And just attack face, in this case. That's it.
There we go. Alright.
Yeah, this card, the Automation Expert, it's good if you manage to steal it for your Singularity, because it will help you against the OTK. If you drop it, it's a defender, like a free defender that you might get. Use your OTK with it. Counter against OTK, I might say. So this guy is not playing a meta deck. At least I think he's not. So here I would say like go with the Cunning Diplomat to see what you get. You could even drop the... I'm just thinking out loud. You can bank the Spectre here, the Spectre Craft, or yeah. Or play it. Play the Spectre better.
Okay, so I would bank something else?
Yeah, I would say... let's see. You can bank the Baron, the two-cost card, the Baron.
And then we play the Spectre aircraft?
Yeah, correct. And attack the Nestor with your...
Nestor.
With your Honor Steward, yep.
Got you. Alright, that seems to be it.
Yeah. I mean,
good stuff.
This is a good setup.
I think this is one of our better games.
Yeah, definitely. This, I would say he's not using like the meta cards that are usually used. But well, it's fine either way.
Meta existed for a while.
This meta?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's already been here a while. So
okay.
I would attack with a Spectre directly to the security officer. Since it has evasive, you don't need to worry about defender. You draw a card first also. See what do we get.
Hey, okay.
Yeah, so here you can drop, I would say you can drop the Siphoner, the 5 cost card. We might overdraw here, but it doesn't matter. Okay, get that one. That's a 0 cost card that you can play right away.
Mm-hmm.
I would bank the Spectre. I say, bank your Spectre and play the Life Siphon on the 1-1. and the automation expert. So you have it, on your singularity. Now, if your Sacred Siphoner dies, which is your 5-cost card, it will return. You will be able to look for that automation expert, and he's a great weapon to counter the OTK because it has Defender. And basically, when you play the OTK, you can't do anything else on your turn. So if you have a Defender and you can't kill it with what you have on board, you basically can't do the OTK. So that's why defenders are very important against this matchup, against Augenkor OTK. Yeah.
Would you say that this deck we're playing now is one of the more complicated decks to play? It feels like there's a lot of setup involved and extra calculations you have to do with the singularity. But I haven't played all the other decks yet, so I'm curious.
Yeah, you could say it's difficult.
It's not beginner friendly, I'd say, is the word.
Yeah, not beginner friendly.
So I'd picture a lot of pros play this deck then.
Yeah, right now some of the top players are playing it. Yeah, that's why we have two of them in the list.
That's what I thought. Yeah, it reminds me of a different deck in Gwent I used to play back in the day. Okay, our turn. So
yeah. So we make the Saboteur here, the 3-cost card you have there, the Saboteur.
Okay.
We don't want to destroy any relics right now. Here, I would say, you have many options. You can... We want to kill that... that Machinist, the 5-cost card there, because it just pops out those dogs every turn. So I would go with the... I would go with the Honor Steward here. Honor Steward to kill the 2/3 token, the Nestor.
Sorry.
No worries.
You said 3/2 and I was picturing the other one. I should have read it. Text is a bit tiny. I have to enlarge it sometimes. Okay, sorry.
Yeah, so attack with your Siphoner on the Nestor, the Defender one. Yeah, with your Siphoner.
Here.
Attack that one, and just attack face with that apparition. Let's see if you can bank. Can you bank something? No. So just use the PS8 on the little dog. Yeah.
The hound. Okay.
Well, it didn't go through. It's fine.
Oh.
It's fine. We're super good here.
Yeah, sorry, for me I have to just enlarge the card so I can just memorize some of the names.
Yeah. Yeah, that's why we're doing this today, for you to get familiarized with
Of course.
Also with all the cards and you will get it pretty quick.
Yeah, I'll probably be streaming up almost all day tomorrow just playing these decks.
Nice.
Yeah. Very nice. No, I appreciate the help. Yeah, climbing some ranks, that would be fun. Marco is the worst. What's Marco?
Marcolian is it's another one of the parallels. Marcolians is the red parallel. They are practically the most beginner friendly. They are super aggro deck.
Okay. I like the aggro decks. I don't know what that says about me.
Go face. Face is a place.
Yeah, I always end up playing those types of decks. Which one do we prefer?
Yeah, you recover the Machinist, the 5-cost card. So now, as you recover it from the Singularity, when he kills your Honor Steward, the Honor Steward won't bring back the Machinist to his side, because you now have it in your hand. That's a really cool thing you can do with it. So I would bank the Saboteur here again, and play the Fanatical Crewman. the three costs, the financial crewmen. And play the siphoner. The other siphoner you have there. Let's see what
sacred one?
Yeah, the sacred siphoner. And get the foreman. That I mean the expert. The automation expert. The one on the right. The three cost. Yeah. Get him and kill his juggernaut token. Here.
Honor steward?
Yeah, with honor steward. Yep.
Well, let's go.
Yep.
Nice.
Finally a win.
Nice. We won.
Amazing. Yeah. So you wanna keep on trying the other decks, or you like this one?
I'd love to try every deck at least once. Yeah. I think we've not played the Juggernaut Workshop, Defender of Earth.
Yeah.
And two stewards.
Yeah.
Now I think we have these two left.
Yep.
So which one is the most fun, you said? Let's keep that one for last.
Well, the most aggro one is the number 5. That's the aggro. So we're going to go with 3.
Let's do 3 and then we end with the 5 and see how that treats us.
Yeah, let's go with 3. Yeah, okay. This is Catharis. They are like clones. To explain a bit of the lore of the game.
Mm-hmm.
They are clones. Well, basically all the parallels were from Earth like 10,000 years ago, and then something happened to Earth and they had to move, so that's where the parallels formed. This parallel, the Catharis, are in Jupiter, I think, and they're like clones, and they have all this technology surrounding cloning people and stuff. So I think this is my favorite parallel and the one that I play the most.
Okay.
So yeah, let's see how we do. We're going against the aggro guys, which are the Markolians. So yeah, here we definitely want to keep the mercenary gunslinger. You can return the one of the two cost cards that you have there, the standard bearers, and the three cost card. You can return it also.
I think the only thing I'd like to do, beta feedback, is make these cards bigger in certain instances. I don't know, maybe I need glasses. I'm gaslighting myself right now.
yeah, definitely.
But good otherwise, feedback there.
So here,
really cool. Yeah.
With this Paragon, when you bank a unit, you get like a little token. That's a 0/1 token. So
okay.
I would say like bank the three cost card, the unit, the ATN subjugate, the one on the right. Yeah, that one. And you play the slinger here to kill his token. The 1/1 token.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so you get that board advantage here.
Yeah. Turn. Okay, let's go clones.
Yeah, someone corrected me, said they're from Europa, a moon of Jupiter.
Europa. They're from Europe? No wonder. Probably France.
Yeah, exactly. So he played a slinger here. So now when you bank another unit, your little token, the CPU's adjutant buffs, gets one attack.
Okay.
Yeah. You have the Cunning Scipion, which is the two cost card on the left. It generates a token at the end of the turn, a 1/1 token. And the one on the center gives whatever token you play, whatever unit you play that is a clone, it gives it +1/+1. And if you generate another one, you have like a little nice combo where you like buff a bunch of units. So here I would say to, you can, I would say, bank the standard bearer, which is the unit in the middle. The Valorous standard bearer, yeah, that one, and play the Cunning Scipion here, which is the other unit you have.
Yes.
And you can attack the little token, the 0/2, with your token. Well, yeah, try that. The shield pod has defender, so he might choose to defend with it, like he just did.
Okay.
So yeah, here we're setting up a nice advantage, nice board advantage, where now you end your turn and you will generate a token with your Cunning Scipion.
Nice.
Hopefully one of these units survives this turn, so you can attach that upgrade called the Memento of the Fallen, which is a very nice legendary card.
Determines if a card is a legendary. It's rarity?
Yeah, it's rarity. It's legendary. It's okay. You can only play one of them per deck. One copy per deck, yeah. So here I would bank Koso, the 5 cost card you just draw, and attach the Memento to your Cunning Scipion. Yeah, to the 2 cost unit, the Cunning Scipion. So here you kill the shield pot with your token, with your little token.
Okay.
Yeah.
My token being the 1/1?
Yeah, that one that can attack.
Okay, let's go.
And just attack phase. Oh wait. You can actually attack that unit, the vengeful ally. You can attack it. You won't die. You will keep your board. And he will be weaker.
Mm-hmm.
This vengeful ally buffs itself every time a unit dies. A unit from their side dies. But as you saw, the shield bot, since it comes with comes at the start of the game, it doesn't bring the benefit of buffing the vengeful ally.
Yeah. Yeah, or else we would have attacked this card first.
Yeah, so now you have the Memento attached. The Memento is very powerful here.
I like this deck so far.
Oh, he conceded.
There we go. I'm gonna be honest, yeah, that was... I quite like that. I wouldn't mind playing that deck again.
Yeah, let's do it. Let me go for a glass of
a
water.
Quick break.
Yeah.
Of course, go.
Right,
thank you. Let's see if I can screw up our rank. Yeah, that was simplistic enough. The token generation with clones. I like that. But maybe I'm biased because we won. That deck is the token master, so many units with a few powerful buffs for wincon. Gotcha.
Okay, I'm back.
Just in time.
Yep.
Alright.
So yeah, here... We don't need the fixer since this we're playing against a deck that generates a lot of units.
Mm-hmm.
You can also remove the Immunus, the Enduring Immunus, which is a 3-cost card.
Yes.
And I think we're fine, or let me see. I think we are fine with this hand. So we have Magna, the 3-cost card you see there. It's a legendary card.
Mm-hmm.
Right now, I think we go and back, we go ahead and bank the Aetean subjugate. And I would kill the token with a PSA tier. Yeah.
The 1/1.
Yeah, the 1/1. Just to establish board presence and
yeah,
maybe get that that buff on your token.
So we will play our parallel at what point in this game? What's the plan?
So our Paragon is Scipius.
Paragon, sorry. Yeah.
Yeah, he triggers all the monster abilities that you have played this game. So we will see what do we get, and when we get a bunch of monsters, we will drop him when it's needed. So here I would go with the Cunning Scipion, the one we played before, and bank the Standard Bearer, the 2-cost unit. Yeah, bank that one. Go with a Cunning Scipion. And just attack the 0/2 token with your Scipius Adjutant. That's it. Now, if he kills one of your units, you will be able to play Magna for free, in the sense that you will get all her effects, which is attack phase, which is damage to face, damage to a unit, and draw a card. If not, you might just play her and do one of the effects that I just mentioned. So let's see what he goes with here. Usually in this turn they play a card called the Longbow Carrier. He didn't, so we should be fine. He killed the token, so you will be able to clear his board now, that which is very good. So
okay,
what you do now is clear his shield pot and his Machinist, which is the 1-cost unit. I would say bank the Master Poisoner, which is the 4-cost card you have there. Bank that. And play Magna. Magna is the 3-cost, yeah, that one.
The Legendary.
Legendary, yeah. So Magna, now you choose an enemy unit to deal damage equal to her attack, which is 3. You can kill it easily.
Yes.
You will do 1 damage and draw a card. And that's it. We go. Now you control the board and he conceded. Yeah.
Thought he would.
Yeah, this deck, once you like control the board like this, is really difficult to... It just snowballs at some point, and it's really difficult to deal with.
Wanna play this? The other deck.
You can try. However you want. If you wanna like finish a match with other.
Let's try the final deck, and then we can pick our favorites. Okay. So far, that clone deck was my favorite deck by far.
Okay. Let's go with the
aggro.
With this one, yeah, the aggro, the super aggro. Yeah. This deck is Marcolians, the guys from Mars.
Uh-huh.
They are like very aggressive people.
okay.
In the sense that this is a deck that has like cheap units, cheap cards, a lot of damage to the face, like effects that deal damage. Cards that deal damage to the face. It's absolute madness. And the assault mechanic. Okay, so So here we, like, as you can see, like, you redraw all the expensive ones, which are the 4 cost cards and the 5 cost card.
Okay. Keep the ones?
Yeah, and keep the ones.
Yeah.
Ooh. Artillery Bowly.
So we start off with 2 tokens on the board with this deck.
Yeah, we start with 2 tokens.
And so we build them into our deck?
What's up?
So what do we build that into our deck, or it just comes with this faction?
So the 1/1 token comes with the with
Paragon.
This Paragon, yeah, with Lemieux.
Yeah.
So here I would say many things to do. Definitely attack with the token to the Singularity Steward and kill it with a PS8. The thing is that what do we bank here? I would say the 4 cost card. And just kill that that's in, 2 weak with a PS8.
Singularity, yeah.
Yeah, next turn it's gonna be good. Yeah, you can pass it on. So next turn you drop the Machinist and the Heavy Weapons team, which are the 1 cost units that you have on the left. This card that he dropped makes the effects for him cheaper. The Engine Whisperer.
Okay.
Yeah, I guess you can bank Artillery Bowly, the legendary card, the 3 cost legendary card. I feel that you won't be using it, since you will be the one controlling the board here with a lot of units on the board. So now you drop the Machinist and the Heavy Weapons team. That will set you up for your next play. So yeah, that's this deck goes around that card that you just draw. Now
okay.
Attack phase. You're gonna attack phase. So this deck goes around the Longbow Personal Carrier, which is a 3 cost card that you just draw.
Mm-hmm.
It's placed in a way where when you play the Machinist, it will draw that card, because that's the only vehicle. The Machinist draws vehicles, so you just like place 1 vehicle in the deck, and makes it so that you will draw that that card. So the Heavy Weapons team deals damage to the face at the beginning of the turn, deals 1 damage, which triggers your assault mechanic by itself. And now you basically can play your longbow. Here I would bank the 2 cost unit you have there. Yeah, that one. And play the longbow. This card will summon 2 other units. When you have assault, when you trigger assault, you can see it there.
Mm-hmm.
And this card has defender also, the longbow.
Gotcha.
Yeah. So here you attack phase, or yeah, you attack. I would say you attack phase, or kill the Engine Whisperer, since it gives him advantage with effects. Yeah, that's fine. So you have that card called the Fire Support Base, which is the 4 cost card that gives +1/+1 to every unit.
Mm-hmm.
That you can play it next turn. But what I like to do here is that you can play another longbow next turn with a Machinist that you have in hand.
Okay.
And again, especially against Shroud, when you go with like a white board, it's super difficult for them to deal with that.
Cheer. Yeah, I can see how this is an aggro deck. Makes sense.
Yep.
Makes sense.
And yeah, the longbow has defender, so you can defend with it. But yeah, he's gonna use erasure, sadly, here. Very sad. Not much of a problem. since you will still be able to play a bunch of stuff again.
Yeah.
You can bank the heavy weapons team you have in the hand. Drop the Machinist, the one cost card. The one cost unit. You will draw another longbow, most likely, because there's a legendary card. Yeah, you draw it and play it.
Yeah.
Now you are stacked again. An attack phase.
Yeah.
So if you kill, you don't want to kill the Nova's the other card that's there, because that vanishes when it dies and it will buff the Singularity Steward, so you just go face.
Love it.
Yeah, this is super aggro style.
I like it.
Ooh, the Earthbreaker Cannon in this deck. Wow. Crazy. So here you have two options. You can play the Paragon, which with Assault buffs your units +1/+1 to everything, gives you a unit from your waste, and destroys a target enemy unit.
Mm.
So he's gonna buff his Singularity Steward a lot, which is fine, because you can then play your Paragon and destroy it. He killed your heavy weapons team.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but you have to first attack phase to trigger assault. Attack phase with any of your units. Now you will trigger assault of the Paragon to your left, to Lemieux, the five.
Do I need to bank something first?
Oh yeah. You can bank the Happy Trigger Trooper. It's fine. So you want to kill here the Singularity Steward. Get back your Machinist. Yeah, one on the right. And now you can kill that Honor Steward and get back whatever he stole from you,
uh-huh,
which was a longbow. You can kill the Honor Steward.
Nice.
Yep,
deck feels good.
It.
Yeah. So I get it back every time I kill a Singularity, or did I trigger a specific card that allowed that?
So
refresh my mind.
When he played the Honor Steward, the one that killed your longbow, he sent it to the Singularity. But when you kill the Honor Steward, he gives you back the card that he stole. Unless he gets it from the Singularity into his hand, you won't get it in that case. But since it was still in the Singularity, you get it back.
Okay.
Yeah. So here you do the same thing, like the Machinist, the Machinist and Longbow, and just go face first to trigger Assault and get the Machinist rolling again. Ooh, perfect.
Very nice.
Yeah, that's a legendary card that is very powerful. So here I would bank the two cost cards. Yeah, bank that. Attack phase and drop the Machinist and the other longbow. The one cost card of the
Fleet
Crimson
Machinist.
Crimson Fleet Machinist. There you have it. Yeah, play the longbow again. So, Shroud on turn 8 has a card that's called Demolecularize that wipes your whole board. But since he's still 2 turns away from turn 8, you can deal a bunch of that. Drop that Slinger also. Drop that little Jabroni and attack face. You basically, well, yeah, click the face to deal the damage. Attack face and yeah. Yeah, well, that zero doesn't do anything, but that's all right.
It's to make a
statement.
Yes.
To make a statement. Nice. So yeah. At this point, you either drop the fire support base and probably a determined assault. So you want to drop that 4 cost card you have there. So when the Honor Steward banishes, he banished your Paragon, which is Lemio.
Mm-hmm.
Now you don't get it back, because okay. Paragons just get lost in the.
Okay.
Whatever. So the 4 cost card, the fire support base, is the one you want to drop here and attack face.
Wow.
Yeah, it buffs everything and deals a ton of damage.
That's awesome.
Yeah, you're enjoying the aggro style.
I love it.
And no, wait.
I won't.
You have Determined Assault, which is an aggro card also. You have to bank the So, okay. You want to play the Determined Assault, which is the 2 cost card effect you have in hand to the left.
Got you.
On the face. Attack face. Like...
Okay.
Drop point it out to the face.
Mm-hmm.
And bank the Bannerman, the 1 cost card. You already won, even if he wipes your board. Because next turn you're gonna use the same card, Determined Assault, and then you're gonna play the 5 cost card, the Lancer tank, the orange one. You see there?
Yes.
The Lancer tank, when it drops with Assault, it deals 4 damage to the face. So that's 7 damage in total, and yeah, it's over. It's Joker. Yeah, this deck is really strong against Shroud. He didn't even play Demolecularize.
Yeah, I mean, we're doing much better against this deck than when we played something else earlier today, that's for sure.
Yeah.
shall I accept?
Well, here you could have defended with one of your longbows, so you didn't lose the.
Okay.
The buff, but you already like. It doesn't matter at this point. The thing is that was the correct play to defend with the longbows. The longbows have defender.
Two.
It gets really annoying if you're playing against Markolian and they have longbows and fire support bases because they both have defender and you can just. Make it so they don't kill your buff, which is the fire support base.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, here just drop the Determined Assault on his face and drop the Lancer tank or just attack face and whatever you want to do.
Easy.
Ton of damage in the hand.
Nice.
Which one do you like the most? This one or the Cathari? The Markolian or Cathari?
So, I mean, it's hard to say. How much games do you have left in you? I need to do 2 more to complete the ranking. Do you want to do one of each and we see?
Okay.
It's between this one and the Cathari. So if you'd like, we can quickly do one more of the Cathari, and then
Go ahead.
Tomorrow I'll start maining one of them.
So definitely you like them the most.
So far. The others, they had some cool abilities. I do still want to try that Earthen deck as well tomorrow a little bit to see what it's all about. I can also see this aggro deck falling apart when you don't manage to win quickly enough, because you need a strong board presence in order to activate a lot of these cards, right?
Yep.
So I can see it losing, against an experienced player.
Yep.
Okay.
So here you want to keep your Bannerman and your Determined Assault. Your Markordian Bannerman and Determined Assault. That's
okay.
What you want to keep here.
Yeah. So Determined Assault is... do we ever play that early on? Attack ourselves early on? Or do we specifically wait until later like we did this just now?
In the case against Shroud, for example, if he goes with a Singularity Steward here, the Determined Assault will come in handy.
Okay. Okay, yeah, sure. That makes sense. I was thinking about face.
So, here, you actually... We actually have to... I would bank the two-cost card, the Improvised Tactics, which is the one that you draw.
Mm-hmm.
And I would say play the Bannerman? Yeah, the Bannerman.
Bannerman, okay.
And just attack face.
Mm-hmm. See, what I like about aggro decks is you can climb ranks really quickly if you're good. Because the games end quickly, right?
Yeah. I mean, aggro decks should be used to rank.
Yeah.
That's
what I think.
Yeah. Definitely. There's, if you want to rank, that's what you
there's
want
this use. One deck in Disney Lorcana, right? Where it's the whole goal of the deck is to go as long as possible so you can build your mana the same way you're doing it now, banking your cards. And then if both players do that, it can take 30 to 40 minutes to finish a game.
Oh,
so I'm so scarred that right now I just... Aggro decks are my favorite thing in TCGs at the moment.
Wow.
Yeah.
So...
Okay.
Yeah, here definitely we have to think what we want to do, because...
Yeah.
We can kill the Singularity Steward with Determined Assault here, but then mm-hmm. we won't be able to set up to get the longbow with the two tokens next turn.
Okay.
So,
okay.
We might play the Machinist and the Heavy Weapons team.
Got you.
And we will have the setup either way. He won't be able to kill everything. We will be able to trigger the assault.
So, okay.
So yeah, I think we bank... I think here we will have to bank the Determined Assault. If he... And save our artillery volley.
Got you. And you'd like to play the Machinist and the Heavy Weapons team?
Correct.
Got you. Alright.
An attack phase with the...
Attack phase.
Yep.
Okay.
There you go.
Alright. Yeah, I'm curious to see what the meta is going to look like in the tournament. Now that I have a better understanding for certain matchups, I'm curious. I do still think people are going to end up playing this Steward Eternal type deck. I can already see the pros playing a complicated version above an aggro version, you know? Unless this is a particularly good matchup for aggro. I don't know. I guess people are going to want to counter this purple deck. I'm
they
not
will.
Sure what counter
they
is.
Can. Like, this is a good counter. Right now,
uh-huh.
he's taking a bit, like, even in this scenario, you're still okay.
Yeah.
With what's going on. Ooh, he went for the heavy weapons team. I think he's going to kill it.
Ooh, yeah. Okay. Big brain.
Big Brainiac. Either way, we want to attack phase to trigger the assault and play our longbow.
Yes.
He won't be able to kill it. Yeah, we want to bank that card. Or, well, actually, you know what? Let me see that four cost card that you just drew. The other one, yeah. Target card. Oh, nice. So, yeah, go back.
Mm-hmm.
I would say bank the artillery volley at this point and attack phase and play one of the longbows. You should be alright soon. He won't be able to He will kill your longbow, but yeah, attack phase also again. And
so,
yeah.
Gotcha. Do we normally play our Paragon on turn 5 with this deck? If we have a setup, do we prefer to play him on turn 5?
We most likely will play it on turn 5.
Gotcha.
We want to play the longbow again. Next turn. Oof. Sag.
Ouch.
Doesn't matter, we can still play the longbow. He's gonna attack phase. Wild. Big mistake. Big mistake by him.
Yeah, you're not the aggro deck, buddy. That's our job.
That's our job, exactly. So here we, I would say, bank that 5 cost card you just draw, the Annihilate.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, bank Annihilate. That. Attack base and play the other longbow. You can also play that crack shot, the 1 cost card you just draw. That's ghost face.
Nice. Are there, besides banishing all the cards, wait, I deal 3 damage to the enemy.
Yeah, to the face.
Besides damaging all the cards, you said on turn 8 or something there's a card that can do that in the one faction? Are there cards that damage wide? Like, 2 points of damage for each card on the board? Like, is that a thing I should worry?
Well, the only other card that does that, that deals damage to everything, it's that one, the Artillery Bowly, the one that we banked. You can see it there in your bank. If you click your bank, you will see it. He's in a pickle, a big pickle.
Like how you... I know things get serious when Quinto starts saying pickle. If you ever played poker, that would be your tell, is when you start using the terminology pickle.
Yeah.
I start swearing very softly, but I am not allowed to swear on my stream, so it's hard.
Okay, fine. So here, definitely, it's attack phase and drop Lemieux.
Okay.
You will bank that, that PS8, the one that you just draw.
Uh-huh, okay, I'll bank that.
Bank that. Attack phase Lemieux. First.
Okay, Lemieux is our Paragon, gotcha.
Yeah, and drop Lemieux.
Big boy.
Big boy to the face.
Nice.
Destroy the Singularity Steward, obviously.
Oh yeah, if I picked anything else, this whole day would have been a waste.
Yeah.
He'd be like, my coaching was wasted.
Just attack face. At this point, attack face.
For sure. This deck feels good. I mean, I might start off playing this, to be fair.
Ooh,
in terms of complexity, from a beginner's standpoint, I'd say this is by far the easiest go-to deck.
Yeah.
Again, that Earthen deck, I still kind of want to give it a shot. Maybe we end off with that deck instead of the other one. Because the clone deck, I understand. It has a bit more tiers to it. So it's it's not more difficult per se. Actually, it's very easy, to be honest. But the Earthen one, I think if we can give that one more shot, I'd love to end off with that for our 10th game of the day. And then I think we can end the stream and I'll do a longer stream tomorrow on my channel and start bringing everybody into it. I mean, unless you want to go on, but I mean, I think...
No worries. The idea was for you to watch and learn every meta deck.
And I appreciate it. Yeah. And you have an academy or something you guys are running for this type of stuff as well, don't you?
Well, we're still working on that. But yeah, we will announce that soon. All the details.
I saw the Twitter handle somewhere, so it caught my attention. I'm sure that's something I'll join. If you guys do start that would be great. I think a lot of people will be keen to join.
Yeah, Yeah, I'm happy to have you there. It will be amazing. So yeah.
Great stuff.
Yeah, for sure. So here, I would say, you still don't have lethal. So what did he steal from you? Can you see his singularity? No, that's a waste.
Sorry.
He stole, oh my God, I don't even know what he stole. So I would go back. Okay, I will clear his board and use that repurposed stuff on his Honor Steward. On the 4-4 card, yeah.
Okay, want me to play it?
Yeah, just that. All right. There. Or, you know what? Just attack face instead of clearing.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. And okay. Bank, you know what? Bank one of your fire support bases. Yeah, bank that.
And then face?
Save that in case we need an assault, yeah. If we get an assault card.
So, we need assault for all our machines? Or do just some of them have the keyword assault?
Some of them have it.
Yeah, I see a lot of them have it. That's a new mechanic. I like that. I like that, having to attack face first. Or just the enemy, it seems. So any card, I assume.
Did he attack face? Crazy.
Did he do it again?
It seems he attacked face.
I mean, if he wins, that's gonna be like, ouch.
No.
Like,
he's not gonna win. So you drop that Nura. Let's see what you get first. Ooh, perfect. Okay, so drop Nura. The 3 cost card you have there.
Okay.
Drop her. Vehicle. Shoes vehicle. Yeah, this is a combo that you're gonna use with a 5 cost card you have in the hand. So attack face. Yeah, and bank the fixer, the 4 cost card. That, yeah. And use crack shot on his face. Use crack shot on the face. The effect, yeah. Crack shot. Yeah,
nice.
Yeah, so next turn you win. Already.
Yes, very
so
nice.
So end turn, because read the Earthbreaker. Oof, double. So read the Earthbreaker cannon, the 5 cost unit you have.
This unit gains shielded after another friendly vehicle, and so this unit deals. Oh wow, very nice.
Yeah.
After another friendly vehicle.
So now all like Nura, the card you just played, the legendary 3 cost card, she makes everything a vehicle. So now your little units deal 5 damage if you play them alongside the Earthbreaker cannon, plus the mercenary gunslingers deal 1 damage each. So it's gonna be 12 damage to the face that you're gonna be able to deal. So you play the Earthbreaker, the cannon first.
Earthbreaker cannon, okay. Yeah.
And bank the fire support base.
Mm-hmm.
And play the slingers on his face. We'll just deal damage, deal 5 damage. Yeah, it's over.
Yes, nice. Okay, well, this is my favorite. Absolutely, by far my favorite. Hell yeah. Okay, well, if I do get cards on some website, it's probably gonna be this one.
What do you mean?
If I get some NFT cards for this game, it's probably going to be this deck.
Oh, yeah.
That makes sense, right? If I'm playing this deck, I probably want to get these cards first.
Correct.
Sure.
Correct.
Okay.
Correct.
Just you need to tell me before I sell my house and go broke fast. I need advice here.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's see. Okay, I picked the earthen one. Okay, so our last game of the day. Yep. And then we'll get a rank placement, which is cool.
Yep. Let me be right back really quick.
Of course. Oh no. Now we're playing against what we played. It's karma. Oof. You can get a starter Markolian deck for 0.01 Aetherian. Really? But do I want a starter deck or the best deck? You see? We're going into this, okay? We're not doing half Caesar, either doing it properly or not. Deal 1 damage to a random enemy, destroy all da, da, da. Yeah, okay, so I have absolutely no idea how this works since we didn't actually get to play this. Are the friendly units have +1/+1? I mean, right now I assume we can't play much, so I'm just gonna have to get rid of these. I would have preferred to play that other deck on my own. Okay, so yeah, we're playing the exact same deck here. Deal 1 damage to a random enemy. Yeah, that seems fine. I'll get rid of the player gains 1 energy, reveal a friendly banked card. This ability doesn't trigger. At the start of your turn, gain 1 energy. That's cool. Draw a card. That's cool. After you play unit, this unit gains 1/1 heal yourself. That's cool.
Awesome.
So, can I throw away this card?
Yeah. So the thing is that you can play that, like, if your Stewie survives, if your Steward of the Garden survives,
yeah,
you will be able to play it next turn. So I would go, like, I would bank the Student of Shoshana, the 2-cost card you have there.
Okay. And then we attack a token?
No. You play the Steward of the Garden.
That card you play for free. Okay. I thought you were referring to the attendant. Okay. Yeah, that makes sense.
Yeah, Steward.
Okay,
yeah,
in turn.
Yeah, hopefully it survives, because then you will be able to ramp.
Yes.
Like a maniac.
Yes. That's what I picked up the first time we played, is the more of these you have, the more you can get out of them, but they need to survive. And we're playing against an aggro deck that's probably going to try and attack phase, so
yeah.
Maybe we get... Uh-oh.
Yeah, but we are playing the counter of this deck. So Earthen is a counter to Markolian. Because we run a card called Virulent Spores. That basically wipes the whole board, deals it infects the units with a keyword called decay. Decay,
okay.
Deals 1 damage to the unit and 1 to the adjacent units, so it's a lot of damage. It's pretty helpful against these aggro decks. So here you want to play the attendant, bank the Aurora Fungi, I would say. The attendant, Efret's attendant, yeah. So you have to activate the ability of the Efrets.
Okay.
You
How
see
do I
it.
Do that?
place your cursor above the attendant. The Efret's attendant. The 3, yeah.
Oh.
Yeah, you see that. You will have to reveal a card of yours so it doesn't give extra energy to your opponent next turn.
Okay, which one?
Whichever, like the Aurora Fungi can be.
Okay.
So the Efret's attendant, when it's on the board, it gives you 1 extra energy each turn to each player. But if you activate its ability, you will block your opponent from receiving that extra energy.
Okay. So what do we do now?
Yeah, end the turn now. You're all right.
Okay.
So you have a lot of energy if all of this survives next turn.
Mm-hmm.
Even if it doesn't, you will have a good turn.
Okay. So if I reveal the card, which I did, only I get 1 energy a turn and they don't, is what you're saying.
Yeah, correct.
Okay. So I mean, you probably always want to do that.
Yeah, you have to do it. You always have to do that.
Yeah, right.
Definitely.
Unless you're trying to hide a very big secret.
yeah, exactly. So he killed one of your ramps, it's fine. We're gonna go with a Cunning Diplomat next.
Mm-hmm. Cunning Diplomat, to draw a card.
Yeah. So the good thing about this deck is that you also prevent the assault damage.
Uh-huh.
So that's a very big benefit. He won't be able to drop the longbows as we were doing before. So yeah, drop the diplomat first, the cunning diplomat. So you draw, and let's see what you get.
Okay.
Yeah, that's like I was telling you, the virulent spores gives decay. Like if he goes wide, you just drop that thing and everything dies. So,
gotcha.
But that also affects your units, but it doesn't matter. You will have stronger units. So here you activate the ability of the Ephrats and bank the one cost unit you have in the hand. And kill the shield bot.
The shield.
Yeah, with your Ephrats attack. Yeah.
Alright. Then we end turn?
Yeah, end turn. So, here you are super good in the sense that he won't be able to activate the longbow.
Okay.
And when he kills your diplomat, you will give defender to the Ephrats. So you will now have defender and keep the ball rolling without letting him attack your face, which is very important in this matchup to block the assault mechanic. Give defender to the Ephrats, yeah, correct.
Okay, yeah.
That's it. And let's see what he plays. He played a longbow by itself. Interesting. Gaia's Call. So, Gaia's Call is a very powerful card, but he might have a counter for it. I would say drop it. drop it.
Okay.
Yeah, drop it. Let's go. Let's do it. You're okay. You should be okay. Bank the Koso. Bank the the 5 cost. Yeah, Koso, and activate Ephrat's ability, so you don't give him extra energy next turn.
I see how this works. Nice.
Let's see if
attack?
Attack the longbow. Yeah.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Yeah, and that's it. So now, the Gaia's Call, the card that you just played, it drops, like when it activates, it will activate in 3 turns. Each turn it will gain a counter. When it has 3 counters, it will activate and basically let you drop all the units in your bank to the field. And all your units will be able to attack that turn. So it's basically a no TK if you have enough units there that can attack.
Okay.
What's up?
Sorry. So OTK, what is it? I know what you mean. I'm just curious. What does the letter stand for again?
One OTK. Turn kill.
One turn kill. There we go. Yeah. Yes. Yeah, sorry. There's so many. Every card game is a different word for everything. So, we also say you can go, can't recall what the other word was we normally use.
Ooh, Vengeful Allies. Could be a problem here.
Okay. Yeah.
So, it's fine. We're okay. We're just gonna... The thing is that when Vengeful Allies in the field, your Virulent Spores becomes not that good. So I think we go ahead and play the Paragon here. Like that's the card that we were looking for, that Formidable Presence. So here, bank the Tain, the 8 cost card, bank it, because if the Gaia procs, it's gonna be very helpful. And drop the Singularity Steward and your Paragon, Nehemiah. Singularity Steward is the 1 cost card. Yeah, Steward of the Garden.
Okay.
There are so many. You play it.
Yes. Yeah, no worries, there's a lot of cards. I know.
So many stewards in this game. So yeah.
Yeah.
And then drop Nehemiah, which is the paragon, to the left. Yeah, your paragon.
Does placing matter in this game or not really?
Yes, it does. It does.
You said to the left. Yeah.
Specifically, yeah. Well, she's on the left. Like, you will find her on the left.
Gotcha.
not to play her on the left, but at this point, it doesn't matter. But it's something that you should be aware of when playing Pyrolands Force or against Pyrolands Force, because the cards that you play on the board that are on the sides of the field won't receive max damage, which is 3. If you have a unit that is sandwiched, it will receive the DK damage for itself and the both adjacent units.
Okay, I understand.
Yep.
Yeah, because sometimes we have a trigger order in games where it goes from left to right, top to bottom, stuff like that. So
yeah,
just curious.
Another 3. Oh my god. Let's see what he does. I mean, so here, bank one of your crew bosses, like the 5 cost units you have. Bank it. Play your Cunning Diplomat. Play that also. And play your Formidable Presence. Yeah, Formidable Presence. This is big damn. So just use the Aurora Fungi, the 1 cost card you have to select. And to the scroll to the right. Quickly. And use that one, the student. Just use them.
Wow, okay.
Yeah, so now attack with the with Nehemiah, you can attack the longbow. Yeah, clear the longbow. And now with your seeds that are indestructible, you can attack face, actually. He won't be able to do anything to you.
Okay.
And then next turn you will receive, your Gaia will proc if he doesn't destroy it. So yeah, end turn now.
Wow, okay.
So if he doesn't destroy your Gaia, so you basically win. He's gonna destroy your Nehemiah. Your paragon. Add defender to the Grove Guardian. The one cost, the one in the middle.
Yes.
Yeah, that one. So yeah, he can't do anything to you because you have the seeds. These seeds have defender and are indestructible. So yeah, now you play Tain. You play Koso.
Wow. That's crazy. Play,
yeah, you will get a card here from him. Ooh, drop, that's Orbital Strike. Drop that in his face. Yeah. That's 5 damage to the face. And now drop the crew boss. Big damn.
Wow.
And now attack face with everything. I think if you bank your Stewie, the 1 cost card, and play the Kriya.
There we go.
It doesn't matter. You had so much damage there, like the Formidable Presence next, and also the crew boss. Whatever you played, well, you got 2 platinum, 1. That means you're diamond soon.
All right. What do the ranks look like in this game?
It's a master, then comes diamond, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then platinum, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then gold, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, silver, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and bronze.
Okay, so...
So you're about to hit solid. Diamond. Very nice.
Very solid.
Yep.
I mean, couldn't have done it without your help. Appreciate it. Yep. Hell yeah. Okay, well, just in time since I have to hop into my next meeting. But wow, thank you so much again. I really appreciate the help. And I, yeah, I think we're going to have an awesome tournament on Thursday.
Amazing.
Yeah, and I'm super keen to start my parallel journey and be a part of it. I'm going to hook up with Aliestra soon, pick her brain a little bit, because she's going to be casting too. And yeah, guys, if you want to watch me play this on stream tomorrow, yeah, my name is in the chat if you want to go check that out. I just play card games at the moment, so yeah, appreciate it. Thanks again. I am probably gonna sign off then, and yeah,
awesome.
Prepare some
thanks.
More.
Thanks a lot, Thea, for doing this. I hope you enjoy the game and enjoy the coaching. Really excited to see you then on the tournament.